Good morning and welcome to worship on this Resurrection Sunday, this Easter Sunday morning here in Willow, Alaska. I'm standing in front of Willow United Methodist Church and my name is Christina Dowling Soka. I, along with my spouse, Jody Dowling Soka, have the great delight to be the pastors here in Willow, Alaska of the United Methodist Church. And on behalf of the whole congregation, we welcome you to this service of resurrection hope. I'm standing in front of the church, and I've always loved this pillar that supports the church. I love how each stone is laid in there, and I particularly love the shape of the cross that you see there. Today we're thinking about the metaphor of the stone and what it means for Jesus to be the rock in our lives and what it means for us as living stones to be built into the walls of God's resurrection church. Today is a very special service. We are thankful to our musicians, to Mary Lemmings and to Amanda Dale. And we are thankful to our readers. Our readers this morning are Paul Williams and Jeff Bertrand. To participate fully in the service, we hope that you will bring up the bulletin either on one of your devices or download it. You should be able to find the link to the bulletin on our Willow United Methodist Church Alaska Facebook page or wherever you found this video posted. For those of you in the neighborhood, we will try to do an outdoor parking lot celebration of the Lord's Supper at 11 a.m. if the weather cooperates. And I think it is cooperating to a certain extent. But to all of you, we welcome you. At the close of our service, we will be sharing in the Lord's Supper today. And to prepare for that, we would invite you to gather bread and juice or water or something to drink and have that ready for that moment where we share in the Lord's Supper together. What a wonderful way to celebrate the risen Christ. Welcome in the name of the Lord. Join us in the greeting. You'll find the words in your bulletin. The response is, Alleluia, Christ is risen indeed. Friends, the tomb is empty. The stone has been rolled away. Christ is risen.
Alleluia, Christ is risen indeed.
For 3 days he laid in that cold and lonely cave, but God's love cannot be contained by anything. Not even death. Christ is risen.
Alleluia. Christ is risen indeed.
Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? Christ is risen.
Alleluia! Christ is risen indeed.
Come, let us worship the risen Christ. Our hymn is Christ the Lord is risen today, number 302 in the hymnal.
Join me in the community prayer and the time of reflection following. When everything was dark, it seemed that the sun would never shine again. Your love broke through. Your love was too strong, too wide, too deep for death to hold. The sparks cast by your love dance and spread and burst forth with resurrection light. Gracious God, we praise you for the light of new life made possible through Jesus. We praise you for the light of new life that shone on the first witnesses of resurrection. We praise you for the light of new life that continues to shine in our hearts today. We pray that the Easter light of life, hope, and joy will live in us each day, and that we will be bearers of that light into the lives of others.
It's time for our children's message. We'd like to invite the children to come up close to the screen. I wanted to show you all what's on our altar today. Did you know that it is Easter Sunday? And on our altar, we have a lot of symbols of Easter and in our sanctuary. Oh, look at these beautiful flowers, these Easter lilies. They remind us of Easter. In a special way, we plant a bulb in the ground that looks dead, and yet it comes to life with this beautiful, beautiful. And I love how they look like trumpets, shouting the good news, Christ is risen. And over here, of course, we have our beautiful light. And if you look real close, I'm going to show you one of the beautiful banners that we have. Do you see the beautiful butterflies on our banner? Those also are a wonderful symbol of Easter. And today we'll be sharing in the Lord's Supper. We'll be drinking from the cup, some juice, and having some bread. I want to show you a picture of the beautiful bread that we have today. And do you see the symbol that's on the bread? The symbol is a symbol of the cross. I was thinking about symbols. Symbols are things that point to God, that remind us of God. And I was thinking how all these symbols of Easter, how you and I, we can be symbols of Easter too. We can be reminders of how much God loves us and how much God loves the whole world. Today is a day to celebrate. Today is a day to be Easter people. The early church had a special saying when they would gather on Easter. One person would say, "Christ is risen," and the other would say, "Christ is risen indeed." Let's try that. Christ is risen. You say it with me. Christ is risen indeed. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Let's pray. Gracious God, we thank you for the story of Easter. Thank you that we can be living symbols of Easter. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for loving us. Amen and amen. Let's sing Jesus Loves Me. Coming up.
Thank you. is our first reading on Resurrection Sunday. We share a selected verse from Psalm 118. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my might. He has become my salvation. There are glad songs of victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. And the right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day of the Lord that he has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
This is the day that the Lord hath made. Let us sing.
Our Easter reading this morning comes from San Antonio, Texas, and the Gospel of Mark. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they could go and anoint Jesus' dead body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they came to the tomb. They were saying to each other, "Who's going to roll the stone away from the entrance for us?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled away, and it was a very large stone. Going into the tomb, they saw a young man in a white robe seated on the right side, and they were startled. But he said to them, "Don't be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He isn't here. Look, here's the place where they laid him. Go, tell his disciples, especially Peter, that he is going ahead of you into Galilee. You will see him there just as he told you." Overcome with terror and dread, they fled from the tomb. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks for this Resurrection Sunday, and we pray that your Spirit would enliven our hearts, transform us to be like your Son, Jesus Christ. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, for you are our strength and our Redeemer. Alleluia! Christ the Lord is risen. Christ is risen indeed. I love the word indeed. I love singing the songs, Christ the Lord is risen today, and singing at the end of the service. We're going to sing that song in the garden, and he walks with me and he talks with me and he tells me I am his own. I always think of the old preacher joke, which the little boy was praying to God, and he was using the term Andy when he was praying. And his grandpa was saying, why are you calling God Andy? And the little boy said, because it says it in the song. Andy walks with me, Andy talks with me, and he tells me I am his own. I love the songs of this day. I love the symbols of this day, the beauty of these lilies, the beauty of butterflies, the thinking that we have about all the symbols about new life. And today, the symbol that I want to focus on for this Sunday, this Easter Sunday, is a symbol of a rock. The psalmist was going through some hard times. The psalmist didn't even know if they were going to survive in Psalm 118. And yet they do survive. They say these words, I shall not die, I shall live. And I shall live to recount the deeds of the Lord. And then it talks about how the stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. And of course, Christians throughout the ages looked back on this psalm, and they looked back on similar words in the book of Isaiah, and they thought about how Jesus, the one who was rejected, the one who was crucified on that cross, on that bitter Friday, how that same one who was rejected was risen in glory and has become the cornerstone of our lives. I think of so many mentions of rocks in the Gospels. Just last Sunday, when we remembered the Palm Sunday story and the children waving their branches, the shopkeepers waving their branches, and the chief priest said, tell your folks to be quiet. Why are they shouting out in praise to you? And Jesus says, if I told them to be quiet, the very rocks would cry out. And church, as we look at the beauty of the mountains, as we look at the beauty of the skies, we can say how the rocks, God's beautiful creation, does cry out in praise and thanksgiving in celebration of this great God that we serve today. I love the image of the rock for other reasons. We believe that our lives can be built on the solid rock of Christ. Remember that parable where Jesus was saying, don't build your house on the sand, on the sandy land, but build it on the rock. And we, this day, are invited to build our lives on the rock of Christ. Can you imagine yourself on that first Easter morning? As Mark tells the story, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome, they rose way before dawn. They gathered precious spices that they had bought after the Sabbath, and they gathered their wraps around them. And it says as the light of day began to break through, they journey to the tomb. I love it that they're doing all of this preparation in the dark. And they must have had lots of questions, but their biggest question as they were walking along towards the grave was, who was going to roll the stone away? Because you see, the stones in those days, they were, thousands of pounds, a couple of thousand pounds. And the way that the stone of the grave worked, it was in a groove. And it was rolled down, and once it was rolled down to cover that tomb, it would have taken a great number of people, a tremendous energy to roll it back. And so the women are discussing among themselves who will roll the stone away. And yet they go, even with their questions. I love it that we can go to this day, we can come to this day of Easter, and yes, we will have questions. And yet God's love, the story of Easter, is bigger than our questions. In the story, when they get there, the stone is rolled away. There are many things that can rob us of our joy. And if the truth be told, sometimes our hearts don't feel alive anymore. Sometimes they feel as if they are stone. Maybe we've experienced tragedies in our life. Maybe we are just overwhelmed by the complexity of the injustices of the world, and we feel so small in our face, and we don't know how we can make a difference. Maybe we have experienced grief and loss. For whatever reason, we have lost our hope and lost our joy. And yet the good news is that Christ takes the stony portions of our lives and breaks through. Have you ever seen a sidewalk that's a rocky place, and you see a gentle flower cracking through the rock, and the roots burst forth, and the beautiful flower is there? And I believe that's what Easter hope does within our lives. This life wells up, and even the broken and frozen places can be changed and transformed and softened and remolded and shaped, and we can find our hope again. A lot of things can rob us of our Easter joy. In the Gospel of Mark, in the Passion narrative, it says that Jesus was crucified between two thieves. And a man long ago, his name was Fulton Arsler. He was an agnostic, but then he found Christ, and he eventually wrote the greatest story ever told. And he once wrote that there are thieves that rob us of our Easter joy, and those thieves can be named as regrets from yesterday or worries or fear about tomorrow. We have regrets about the past, the times we've lost our way, and we have worries and fear about tomorrow. And yet the good news is that because of Christ, the victory has been won. The good news is that we can plant our lives and build our lives on the cornerstone, who is Christ. The good news is that God's love is bigger than our deepest questions, wider than our deepest fears, stronger than our deepest failures, and his love in the end will prevail. On that first Easter morning, the stone was rolled away. And today, friends, we believe that the risen Christ is here this morning, and we believe that his resurrection power prevails. I believe that Christ is in the freeing business, and I believe that whatever your story, he has the power to bring you new hope, the power to set you free. Many years ago, I used the story of the women going to the tomb in a children's message, and I used to say it's okay, they had big questions, but that God's love was bigger than our question, and it's okay to have those questions. And I gave each of the children a stone to hold during the service. Well, what I forgot was how easily children will drop their stones. And we were meeting in a beautiful gym where a wonderful wooden floors, and all during the Easter sermon, those stones would drop one by one. And I am reminded how the Christ helps us to let our fears and our worries and our failures and our griefs drop one by one. I am told that on some Easter mornings for Easter sunrise, people gather at the Grand Canyon, and oh, I just can imagine how beautiful that would be, seeing the Easter sunrise over the Grand Canyon. And they gather, and at a point in the service where they say that the stone was rolled away, a stone is dropped, and you hear that sound reverberating, how the stone is rolled away, and those reverberations come down to us from 2,000 years ago today, that Christ is in the freeing business. And on Easter, we celebrate how Christ sets us free. There was a time in the gospel when people had stones and they were about to throw them. You remember the woman who was caught in the act of adultery. They were all going to throw their stones in anger against her. And yet Jesus said to them, whoever was without sin may throw the first stone. And one by one, they realized that they had no business judging, and that they certainly were sinful themselves. And so one by one, they dropped their stones and they turned and they left the woman, and Jesus restored her to wholeness and to the community of faith. And I was thinking about the way that Jesus forgives us and sets us free, and that's a big part of this Easter story. From the moment that he said, Father, forgive them, from the cross, to this moment in the Gospel of Mark. You remember how the women went to the tomb and they saw the young man seated on the right side and they were startled, but he said to them, don't be alarmed. You're looking for Jesus of Nazareth was crucified. He has been raised. He isn't here. Look, there's the place where he laid him. And then he says, go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. Oh, church, there's so much grace in that phrase. Go tell the disciples and Peter. If anyone needed the grace of God at this point in the story, it was Peter. He had denied his Jesus. He had denied his Savior. And we so many times deny Jesus, and yet the good news of this Easter morning is that the message comes for even those of us who have failed, even those of us who feel hopeless, even those of us who in so many ways have denied our Lord. And we too can stand on the solid rock of the grace of Christ. Whatever obstacles you may face, whatever failures you may have, God is still in the business of rolling away the stones in our lives and setting them free. You see, church, I believe that Jesus is our cornerstone. And I believe there's nothing more important than, you know, the cornerstone is how they shape the building. And you put the cornerstone in there first, and then you put all the other stones. And the cornerstone helps guide and shape how the building will stand. And later on in the book of Peter, we're told that we're called to be living stones. We are called to make ourselves available to be God. Part of the Easter message is saying, Lord, take me and use me as I am. I want to be a living stone, a living symbol, a living reminder of the good news that Christ is alive and love will win over hate, and hope will win over despair, and joy will win over sorrow. And nothing, nothing, nothing can separate us from the love of God in Christ. My question this morning is, will we let Jesus be the solid rock in our lives? Will we let the Christ roll the stones away and set us free? Will we let ourselves become living stones? I want to share a story as we close before we move into communion. The story is told of a Sunday school class. This was in Orlando, Florida. The children were learning about Easter. The teacher told the children about the story about the stone being rolled away from the tomb. And then the teacher gave each of the children a stone and asked them to write something on the stone that represented what resurrection means to them. Well, the children were busy. Some of them drew symbols and wrote words. They were all making beautiful artwork on their stone. And then there was little Jonathan, a child with needs all his own, a child unique, a child who had experienced a lot of hard moments, and he was always the one who was bouncing off the ceilings. He had become a helper, as you so often do to channel all that energy. The teacher had made him a helper. He was there passing out the stones, and when he finally got down to work, the teacher's name was Nathan. Noticed that little Jonathan was writing his name on the stone. And he thought maybe that Jonathan hadn't heard the instruction. He says, Jonathan, that's okay. Use the other side. On the other side, you can write or draw something that reminds you of the resurrection. And little Jonathan looked at him and said, I am. And Nathan replied, but what does it mean to you that Jesus rose again? How does that make you feel? And Jonathan said, that's what I'm doing. I'm writing my name because, you see, Easter means to me that God loves Jonathan. That's what it means to me. The stone that was rolled away on Easter morning has your name on it. Christ, who is our cornerstone, has our names on that cornerstone. And because of his great love, we can stand in the strong assurance that Christ lives and nothing can separate us from that love. You and I, we can become living stones. Won't we build our lives on the cornerstone of Christ on this Easter day? Let us pray. Oh God, our message this morning has been a simple one. It's the simple good news that Christ is risen. And because he is risen, we can drop our stones of judgment. Because he is risen, we can build our lives on the solid rock foundation, which is Christ's love. Because he is risen, we can hold on to hope. We can hold on to joy. We can hold on to life. We can hold on to love. And so, Lord God, we place ourselves in your hands on this Easter morning. Go before us and lead us to the places and the people you would have us meet, to the places and the people that you would have us love, to the situations which call for your justice and your wholeness and your peace. Make us your Easter people this day. We pray in the name of the one who is our cornerstone, in the name of the risen Christ. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Our response to the word is, "Thine be the glory." Let's sing. To give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, brought us to a land flowing with milk and honey, and set before us the way of life. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your child, Jesus Christ. Jesus lived among us to show us your love, caring enough to feed hungry persons, stopping to touch persons in need of healing, reaching out to those not like himself, a Samaritan woman at the well, lepers from another country, those tortured by demons, a father pleading for his daughter, a woman from Syrophoenicia, Zacchaeus, a tax collector, a rich young ruler, and humble fishermen. When people gathered to hear his teachings, Jesus took bread, blessed it, and broke it, and gave it to them to eat, so that they might be fed. When Jesus ate with his disciples for his final meal on earth, they remembered his blessing on the multitude and listened as he told them, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." They watched as Jesus took the cup, blessed it, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for the whole world for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." On the day you raised him from the dead, Jesus was recognized by his disciples in the breaking of the bread. And in the power of your Holy Spirit, your church has continued in the breaking of the bread and the sharing of the cup. And so, in remembrance of your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as holy and living sacrifices in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ and one with each other and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever.
Amen. And it is as children of Jesus that we pray his prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
We would invite you now to take your bread. And together we would break the bread. The bread which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ. This is the body of Christ broken for you. And together we would take the cup. And remember that this is Christ's love poured out for us all, the gift of God for the people of God. The blood of Christ shed for you.
Amen. And the blood of Christ shed for you.
Amen.
Let us pray.
Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Our hymn is In the Garden. It's number 314 in the United Methodist Hymnal. I come to the garden alone while the dew is still on the roses.
Thank you.
Happy Easter, dear friends. Happy Resurrection Sunday. We pray that you have been blessed. We pray that you will go forth as Easter people with Christ as your solid rock foundation. Go forth to be living stones, sharing the good news that Jesus lives. We pray that you will also be generous as you go from this place, generous to yourself, generous to your neighbor as Christ defines neighbor, and generous to your church. You are a loved child of God. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Thanks for joining us today.